喂，我是凯威。哎，你好，那我想问一下，明天有关于程式更新的部分，那你这边是要怎么用调整？
Confirming details with his client, 28-year-old 陈凯威 is an engineer coming all the way from Pingdong to work in Taipei. It has been 3 years since he started working in Taipei as he drifted northwards for more opportunities.
当初其实一开始也是在屏东找工作，那其实找了一阵子之后，发现其实薪资的都没有一个在理想的状况，所以才来看比较偏北部的工作。物价不论是吃的或喝的，来这边其实每个都平均大概贵个5块至10块都有，大部分都被房租吃掉一大半。
那怎么还会想来台
北？台北的环境、工作环境跟薪资起伏，我觉得跟南部还是有很大的差距，会比较有发展。那我有个朋友，其实他现在还在屏东，那也是做从事相关资讯业的工作，那他的薪资其实大概26到28，这是屏东的资讯起薪。对对对，那其实跟北部就有一个蛮大的差距。
The same job pays out differently in northern Taiwan and southern Taiwan. Even if the commodity prices are significantly higher in northern Taiwan, many move northwards to pursue a career and explore opportunities on their way up.
以长期来说呢，产业发展重北轻南，薪资上面也呈现了北高中南低的状况。根据比薪水的最新统计，全国平均薪资是来到了41,111元，前四名的县市呢都是由北台湾拿下。
According to data provided by DGBAS, 新竹 ranks first in average salary at 50,163 NTD. Taipei ranks second with 42,464 NTD, while New Taipei City and Taoyuan County fall right behind. The data provided shows an average salary difference of 13,577 NTD, comparing counties in northern and southern Taiwan.
北部的薪资一定会比全省其他地方来得好，不过其实在南部有一些重点的亮点的职务啊，其实有很好的一个发展空间，比如说像南部现在有不少的企业赞助，包含南科或者说有些医院，那为了他们要留住比较好的人才，他们可能就把薪水的条幅提升蛮多的，甚至有像有些医院的医生的薪水可能会多达北部的20,000块钱以上哦。
As southern Taiwan quickly expands, the gap between northern and southern Taiwan's salary difference is being closed.Though experts suggest that, while looking at the differences, the comparison shouldn't be made under the premise of North and South, but instead a broader view on salary trends.
坦白讲，台湾的低薪并不是全面低薪。台湾最近这几年，我们可以看得出来，薪资差距是在扩大，也就是一些高端的管理人才或者是专业人才，就在企业里面的核心的这个部分，他的薪资是一直在往上走。那反而是一些可取代性比较高的低层的这员工的薪资，基本上是反而都没怎么增加哦。那低线是指这一个部分哈，所以这种就从一个公司的高低阶的薪资差距在扩大。
Under the pandemic and along with inflation, young people in Taiwan face troubles in locating jobs with decent payouts. As the salary gap between northern and southern Taiwan starts to close, job seekers need to be on the lookout for specific openings in order to overcome tough challenges. TVBS English News.